Last year, the popular Blaze Blue series celebrated its 10th year anniversary, and it did so in style by bringing Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle to the Nintendo Switch, a high-paced 2D fighter from the stables of Arc System Works. And in that same year, the very same studio was awarded with the title of the best 2D fighting game in Dragon Ball FighterZ, for which I did a Let's Play video during the open beta. And seemingly going all in, they moved Blaze Blue Central Fiction over to the Nintendo Switch, receiving the special edition treatment, and sent me over this review copy to check out. And I have to be honest with you guys, I haven't been this excited about a video game since The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. My favorite game of all time still, and there is so much to talk about, so much to show off. So without further ado, let's dive into Blaze Blue Central Fiction for the Nintendo Switch. Of course, don't forget to enter the Dragon's Lair giveaway and hit that like button if you're enjoying this review, and let's go! After working on the Guilty Gear series, Toshimichi Mori felt the need to create something new. Overflowing with ambitions and ideas, he created our main protagonist, Ragna the Blood Edge, and with that, the Blaze Blue universe was born. Although every character has its own particular fighting style and learning curve, I'm sure that newcomers to the series won't be exactly blown out of the water by the cast of characters to choose from, as there are not as iconic as, say, Scorpion, Sub-Zero, Heihachi, Eddie Gordo, Ken, or Ryu. Blaze Blue Central Fiction is the fourth and final, at least for now, installment in the original Blaze Blue series, as it concludes the adventures of Ragna the Blood Edge. Unfortunately, it is also the only mainstay Blaze Blue game on the Nintendo home console. So if you're new to the series, I highly recommend starting out with the story mode to understand the universe of Blaze Blue and all of its characters and their relationships. In addition to this, there is a vast library incorporated in the game with valuable entries on all of the characters, weapons, powers, historic events, and even a detailed list of all of the terminology used to Blaze Blue and general terms used in fighting games as well. Starting off with the story mode, you're asked if you want to recap the events leading up to the current iteration in this series, which should help get you started. The story mode itself is upwards of 30 hours spread across 100 chapters, plenty of sub-chapters, and even a few gag reels, which are really worth checking out. As mentioned in the introduction, I haven't been this excited for a game since Breath of the Wild, and that is in large part thanks to this story mode. The story as chronicled in Central Fiction is one of the best I have seen in a game in a long, long time, and taken as an anime, which technically it is, it outdoes just about any other I have ever seen. Sorry Goku, sorry Ichigo. I get it, I do. The events in Blaze Blue are hard to follow, the story is deep, it's vast, there's confusion all around. Time loops, people inhabiting other people's bodies, humans, vampires, beastkin, androids, gods, worlds within worlds. But really, it doesn't get any better than this. As you progress through the events, you'll unlock artworks which you can revisit in the gallery, and some of these are absolutely gorgeous. But more on this later, back to the story. Unlike most games out there, this story mode is more theatrical, as the actual gameplay elements are extremely limited. I'd say out of the 30 odd hours, there might be only 2 hours of actual fighting, which requires your inputs. This might be off-putting for some, but if you're into this, there is not much that can rival this. Throughout this game, you'll find some of the best Japanese voice acting around. Whereas the previous entries in the series included an English dub, Central Fiction is only narrated in Japanese with English subtitles, so you better strap yourself in. After finding your footing, or for those not interested in this story at all, I recommend getting down some of the tutorials and a fair bit of training to get used to the elements which make up the actual fighting. And with this iteration in this series, they have added in some new battle mechanics which should be of interest to any longtime BlazBlue player as well. Elements such as the active flow system, which rewards aggressive players with some valuable bonuses, Exceed Excel, a personal favorite of mine to dish out some extra damage in good fashion, and some fine tuning to the overdrive mechanic. Getting a hang of these through the various training modes and exercises is much recommended before heading into any real battle. If you want to juke it out with a friend, simply head over to the Versus mode, select any of the 36 playable characters, stage and background music, and get busy. But just before doing this, you'll be asked to choose between the technical or stylish fighting mode. To anyone new to the series, this is perhaps the most important element in the BlazBlue experience. Ever since the second game in the series, Continuum's Shift, players can select the so-called stylish mode, which in plain words is the perfect way of fighting for beginners, as it automatically strings together basic combos by repeated button inputs and automatically blocks most attacks in idle position. There is no need to make any difficult combo of a quarter of a circle forward whilst pressing B to be followed up with another swing of the joystick and tapping the C button, or pulling off half a circle backwards, then bringing it forward and hit D at the same time in order to execute any of the flashy combos and finishes. It's in a way the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe treatment for fighting games. However, if you do manage to pull off the traditional combos, you'll deal a higher amount of damage, making it the perfect way for getting deeper in the game by learning through practice. In following of the original arcade release, the console version includes an arcade mode in which you can follow the individual stories of each character spread across three stages. Although not all of the characters have all three of the stages, some are limited to only one or two of them. A note of caution, however, if you're sensitive to spoilers and have not finished the story mode yet, it might be best for you to avoid this mode, as it is a very abbreviated version of that in many respects. There are even some interactions between your character and the opponents depending on the storyline's events and personal relationships between them. After clearing any of these acts with your character, you'll see some additional artwork appear in the gallery mode previously mentioned. And now that we're here, let's stick around and have a look, shall we? In the gallery, you can drool away as you flip through the amazing artwork featured in this game. Zoom in and out, move it across the screen, and check out the details you wouldn't be able to appreciate otherwise. As you advance through the story mode and clear out the various acts in the arcade mode, the gallery gets filled up, commemorating your BlazBlue adventures. There are some additional pictures to unlock through the Score Attack mode, in which you'll have to battle through 10 opponents, spread across 4 unique courses, set at 3 difficulty levels. Apart from these, you can buy additional illustrations, some more suggestive than others, for in-game currency, which you earn by raking up victories in the various game modes. Alternatively, you can spend your hard-earned currency in the item shop. Here you can buy background music and additional character colors, which already are set at an insane amount of up to 25 colors for each character. And the absolute cherry on top, the NOL or Null outfit for Noel Vermillion, which can be unlocked in exchange for 50,000 credits, or in other words, just about 15 hours or so of clearing out the arcade mode. However, for those invested in this story, there is an alternative way, as you will be awarded the required amount after the final credits roll. Another way of testing your fighting skills is in the Speedstar mode, in which you'll have to defeat every character in the game within a set amount of time. Defeat your opponents in style by using your Distortion finisher, Overdrive finish, or even Astral finish to keep the timer up and battle onwards. Not only is it worth pulling off any of these three types of finishes to keep on fighting, but just seeing those moves is so freaking awesome. Just have a look at some of these.
と戦えて世界の力が作れる。
Arc System Works know their business and understand their player base. And while the majority of the players might be looking for some plain old fighting, they do have something in store for any RPG fan with an edge. The Grim of Abyss mode is perhaps the most addictive in the entire game. Here you'll have to fight your way through many, and I mean many opponents in various settings, including several so-called boss battles in which the enemies are boosted in every way imaginable. After you successfully pull off your victories, you'll be awarded various grimoires, skills, and items to increase the statistics of your character. And it is this element which keeps you pushing for more. The online component works rather well. While there is some lag during the loading of a battle, during the actual fighting, I haven't experienced any issues. The only thing which didn't seem to work though was the friendly matchup, forcing me instead to try my luck in the ranked matches. For anyone who's really into the online fighting scene, there is a ton to unlock and buy here as well, from character icons to player titles and anything in between. In addition to the option of recording your own battles in this game, here you can also download replays of matches of your interest in order for you to analyze them to improve your own fighting. Now before we move over to our conclusion, I do have to say that for a special edition and with Central Fiction releasing on the Nintendo Switch after the kick-ass BlazBlue cross-tag battle, I had expected at least one battle mode in which tag battle would be possible. No need for any crossover though, just have Ragna and Naoto or Jin and Tsubaki team up in classical tag team fashion. I don't think that would be too much to ask, and it's a shame not seeing this added in as some exclusive content. BlazBlue Central Fiction for the Nintendo Switch is one of the single best games you can ever buy yourself, and probably the best way you can spend $50. It simply is that good. The music is fantastic, the voice acting some of the best I've ever seen in a game, and the graphics are in typical Japanese style over the top. The gameplay is absolutely frantic and the story mode is deep. The story itself running through the entire BlazBlue series is absolutely one of a kind. And admittedly, my eyes welled up at the end when, as I'm sure you'll understand. BlazBlue Central Fiction runs perfectly on the Nintendo Switch in handheld mode using the Joy-Cons, and I have spent dozens of hours playing like that. But when I am at home, I either play using a Pro Controller with bigger joystick because that's just a lot more comfortable, but whenever I have the opportunity, I pull out the arcade stick for the true fighting experience. Really, there's no beating using a good arcade stick, and I'm currently in the process of reviewing a second one, so be sure to stay tuned for that video to drop soon. Where BlazBlue Cross-Tag Battle introduced the Nintendo Switch's fanbase to Ragna the Blood Edge, this Central Fiction is the game where you should really start off, because this is a main story game. But I am sitting on the edge of my seat for Arc System Works to announce the final release date for Guilty Gear, the 20th Anniversary Edition, and see how that lives up to the BlazBlue Central Fiction experience. But the best thing you could do right now, and I'm talking straight to you, Arc System Works, is to release all the previous three installments in the BlazBlue series on the Nintendo Switch. Pack in all of the DLC, slap a special edition or definitive edition label on it, and release it as soon as possible so that the Nintendo fanbase can enjoy Ragna's story in all of its entirety. Now that, my dear friends, is my Central Fiction.